Hi guys, welcome back to Art of Motorcycles, another episode, another day. And today we have got Yogesh sir with us. And as promised, I saw a lot of comments saying that people want to see him. Okay, let's go through the history of motorcycle racing in India. What? Yogesh sir, ready?
Ready?
Yeah. I'll just tell you a brief little thing what I know. As a right racer, I met Yogesh sir in all of my races, wherever I went, and he is the chief scrutineer, and we should literally get afraid of him because we were kids and we were always unprepared. We didn't know that we need to put a split pin on the wheels or making sure that clutch is perfect and the vehicle is in a good condition. And he used to let us know, because that's how he used to make sure that the motorcycles are not in a risky factor when we are racing. Right, sir?
Absolutely.
So,
let me start with, let me continue what you said. It's basically, we come for scrutiny is for your safety, the rider's safety. We need to see that you finish the event and get back in one piece. So that is the criteria for a pre-event scrutiny.
So what are the things what you look at in a pre-event scrutiny?
Pre-event scrutiny is basically safety. Safety checks are done on a particular vehicle. In terms of the tire conditions, your lights working, your split pins on the front wheel axles and the rear wheel axles, so that when you're riding, in case the nut comes loose, it should not fall off. And then we have safety factors like the fuel line clips. A fuel line clip with that pressure in the fuel tank, the pipe might pop off, and you lose a lot of fuel. Probably with a heated engine, it could catch fire also. And there are so many other various factors. Apart from the vehicle, the rider's riding gear, he has to be safe in case of a mishap. So there are certain parameters which has been laid down by the Federation of Motorsports Clubs of India and which we follow.
And when did you start scrutinying, sir?
I have been doing scrutiny for almost 11 years now.
11 years?
11 years.
And what all events annually you are a part of?
I have done a lot of national events like the Karnataka 1000, the MRF Supercrosses. I have done the MRF Supercrosses all over the country, wherever there were events. And promptly Mr. Shyam Kothari would call me and he'd say, I want you there. And a lot of, apart from the national events, there have been other events which I have done also. A lot of club events, mainly. And that also I have done all over the country.
All over the country.
Yeah.
And when we say FMCI, okay, Federation of Motorsports India, what does that body stand for, sir?
FMCI is a governing body. The only governing body in India for motorsports. They lay down the rules, and the rules have to be followed not only by the officials of the event, but as well as the competitors.
Competitors.
We have a set of rules for every group of vehicle, which has to be followed.
What are the different kind of races are there present in India? The category of races.
Oh, there are just too many. Starts at autocross, then goes on to motocross, goes to supercross, and then we have the hill climb races, we have the drag events, we have the rallies, and that just too many. We have the track racing happening at Sri Perambudur and as well as Coimbatore. There are plenty of disciplines in racing.
Okay. So these are the categories of races which are happening primarily.
Correct.
In India.
That's right.
Which is autocross, supercross, motocross. Right. Then we have got drag racing. Then we have got hill climbs.
That's right.
Then we have got circuit track.
Circuit. And the rallies.
And rallies. So these are the categories of racing what we have it in India.
And not forgetting the go-karting.
Go-karting. But in two-wheeler, when we are talking, it's only autocross, motocross, right. rally, right. drag race, yes. and hill climb.
Yes.
When we are looking, there are six categories of racing what we have for two-wheelers. And so now we got to know that you started 11 years back.
Right.
And let's go back. Let's go back and see, where did you start your career in motorcycle?
We came to Bangalore in 1975. And 1976, my father took me to a track racing event in Bangalore called Agram Track, which was on the now old airport road. And that is when the bug bit me.
Wow.
This was way back in 76.
So how old were you, sir?
I must have been about 12.
12 years old.
Yeah. Or maybe 13.
Okay. So how did it begin? Like, the bug bit you when you were 12 or 13.
Mm-hmm.
Then how were the symptoms continued?
Well, that, like I said, that was the beginning of the bug biting me. The first race my father took me there.
Mm-hmm.
And then I would pester him every event to take me to an event.
Mm-hmm.
Till I reached the age where I was legally allowed to race.
When was the first time did you ride a motorcycle? Legally?
No, my dad never allowed me to touch, even sit on a bike, till I got my learner's license.
That was in 16?
18. He did not even allow me to sit on a motorcycle.
Mm-hmm.
And when I got my learner's license, he made sure that he's sitting behind, because that is how it is supposed to be legally. You know, permanent license holder has to be along there with the learner's license holder.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the first time I sat on a bike. My dad took me to Nandi Hills straight away. And this was on a Rajdoot Bobby.
Bobby?
We had the second motor, Bobby in Bangalore.
Wow.
So that was one hell of a trip. I would do about 20, 30, he would hit me on the helmet behind, go faster, he would say. You know, we went right to the top of the hill and came back.
How was the road condition then?
Road condition was okay. I mean, it was a single track road then, not unlike today.
Mm-hmm.
But going uphill was good, it wasn't bad.
Mm.
But now it's definitely better. Obviously,
mm-hmm.
It was good. That was a good fun. My first, I would say, a long distance comparatively.
Mm-hmm. Then, after finishing your first longest ride,
mm-hmm.
when you're 18, you had got your learner's license and your dad was sitting behind, went to Nandi Hills. And how did the racing begin?
Racing began after we sold the Bobby. We bought the Rajdoot 175 motorcycle, which I still own till today.
Mm-hmm.
And a good runner till today, mm-hmm. almost 39 years now. My first race was autocross at the Iblur range.
Iblur.
It was a shooting range again owned by the military.
Mm-hmm.
And there was an autocross there. And I just went there to actually watch the event. And you know, just got my permanent riding license. I had that, said let me take the bike on my own.
Mm-hmm.
I told my dad, you take the car, I'll take the bike.
Mm-hmm.
I went there and I could not resist. I told my dad that I want to ride this event. And I opened the toolkit of my bike
took out all the tools, stripped the bike on the track, removed the headlight, removed the front mudguard, rear mudguard, tail light, the air, everything I removed, the carrier, and I raced.
That was your first race?
That was my first race.
And what happened?
I finished second.
Wow! First race, finishing second.
And I was racing against the king of autocrosses those days, Mr. C.K. Chinnappa.
C.K. Chinnappa. So, I think that's a very good start.
Unfortunately, I don't know where my trophies are. Mm-hmm. I can't show you the trophies.
It's okay, sir. You are sitting in front of us, yeah. And you're talking, telling us, taking us through time. So we are like literally. I'm jammed. So sir, when was this? Which year?
This was in 1980.
I was not even born. Okay, 1980. You had your first race.
Yes.
Then. The second?
The second was a rally which my father rode. I was navigating. Mm-hmm. This was a Yenke night rally. It started at about 5 o'clock in the evening and ended at about 2 in the morning.
What was the route, sir?
It was basically like any other rally towards into the villages of outskirts of Bangalore.
Okay. And nowadays we don't have this night rallying.
Yeah, because there have been clamps on safety part of the thing for night rallying by the federation. Unless you can, you know, satisfy them that regarding the safety part of it.
In fact,
the recently concluded INRC of Jaipur four wheelers, mm-hmm. they had a night stage.
Yeah, one. That's a stage, but it's a stage. There used to be a proper rally.
No, this was, what I am talking about those days, we didn't have the Indian National Championships. Mm-hmm. We used to have this club events, like I said. Mm-hmm. And these are one-off events, probably they would have that event repeatedly every year only. Mm-hmm. We didn't have a series of, you know, championship of five rounds or six rounds for the year.
And the way we look at rally today, where you have got a very big machine and a GPS and they're just gunning the route. Okay, that was not the way it used to be. There used to be two riders.
Correct.
One was a rider, another one was a navigator. As per my knowledge, there used to be 2 meters. The odometer used to be behind, and the rider used to have a slate on his back with a calculator and
a tulip.
In tulip, which shows the direction. And DZ, FZ, yeah, danger. We'll talk about the details.
There was no DZ, FZ those days.
Okay.
It was a basic tulip which was handed over to you 2 minutes before you start the rally.
2 minutes? There was no pre-run?
No. There was no recce, nothing.
Okay.
The tulip was handed over to you 2 minutes before your start time.
Okay.
And you start your zero, your auto, mm-hmm. at the start line. Mm-hmm. And follow the tulip and continue.
Like, even you can't even take a jump, because if you take a jump,
yeah, you'll have an error.
That's
right.
And how was the coordination between you and the rider, sir, with that speed and with both?
Average speeds are given in the tulip. Mm-hmm. So as far as possible, we would, you know, try to follow that average speed. There are certain sections where you cannot. Mm-hmm. Maybe because of road condition, mm-hmm. maybe because of cattle on the road, or probably you'll hit a
dog.
Not a dog. Maybe you'll come across a railway crossing which is closed. Mm-hmm. You could lose anywhere between 3 minutes to 20 minutes.
Wow. And what do you think? You have seen. So you have ridden those rally, and you have seen today, you are monitoring today's rally. What is the difference, and at the same time, what do you think, which was easier?
The old time rallies were being, you know, riding a rider and a pillion, it used to get uncomfortable at times. But at the same time, they were fun. Today's rally is more of speed, more on speed, you know. And the challenges, the competition between the riders, we are talking about fractions of seconds today, between the difference between the first and the second, or even the third. Those days were not that. We used to have the Karnataka 1000 rally running 12 hours late, 14 hours late. Riders would come in 12 to 14 hours late.
Wow.
Because those days, please understand, Karnataka 1000 is 1000 miles, that's 1600 kilometers, run over 3 days.
Continuous.
Of course, we would have a night halt.
Mm-hmm.
But you get to sleep if you're on time.
If you're not on time,
then you don't get to sleep.
That used to be the major scenario.
Major scenario.